bed above the sheets. No one's saying a word, but I can feel your heartbeat. I stare into your eyes and you into mine, lying perfectly still, like we are frozen in time. I don't want this to be over. Don't want the morning to come. My head upon your shoulder, wishing that you would say, I think you should stay. I think you should stay. I want you to say that it's getting late. I want you to stay. I want you to stay.
Oh my God. Oh my God, is he actually going to wear this?
Message is, he will wear this one and only time for you.
Oh my God, I'm so excited. Oh my God, I love that.
Oh my God.
He's gonna keep it on your floor. Oh, there's something else. And look at them, they're so cute. Oh, I love them. One and only. Oh my God. Oh, he's gonna wear these with me! He does love me.
I have pictures, I have proof.
That's awesome. They say bride and groom on them.
You should take the bride one out. It's a great gift.
She's gonna love it.
I love it.
Leather strap.
What'd you get her? The Disney stuff.
Shh. She kinda got it. She opened, she cried. Yeah.
Chad, you better cry.
I gotta thank Katie for that one.
Oh. Fancy football belt. Are you gonna pass that around to everybody?
No, it was signed.
So I'll get it when I win this year?
Yeah, it was signed. Bret Hart. Wow. Nice. Wow. That's awesome. Let's go into Man Cave.
It's a little small.
Card. Read it out loud. No. Sounds good. Oh, I thought it was only that.
It just says thank you, I love you.
No.
Well, what's your name? Can I read it? I can talk.
So, Bret Hart was a wrestler in the 80s, and he had a thing. It was the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. That was his slay. So,
I've heard you say
it. So she goes, you're literally the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. Please have some fun taking pictures with this.
Well, got it bringing out now.
Like we are frozen in time. I don't want this to be over. Don't want the morning to come. My head upon your shoulder.
Oh gee. It's a knife to stab somebody.
Well, that'll be in the video.
Okay, Andy. Come get me. Whenever
get
you
me.
Whenever you feel froggy, I'll slice your ass teeth into fry, buddy.
Now he looks like a Sam.
Wishing that you would say, I think you should stay. I think you should stay. I want you to say that it's getting late. I want you to stay. I want you to stay. We were young, and no one dared to make the first move. You and me in the night, two souls in the moonlight. I stare into your eyes, and you into mine, lying perfectly still, like we have frozen time. I don't want this to be over. Don't want the morning to come. My head upon your shoulder, wishing that you would say, I think you should stay. I think you should stay. My
head upon your shoulder. Oh, you are so gorgeous.
Your shoes look so good.
I know.
It's perfect.
They look great,
honey.
Thanks. You guys look pretty awesome yourselves.
Party.
So well.
Gosh.
Hi, Daddy.
Let me see your sneakers.
Hi. You like it?
Yep.
Want to see the back of it? Yeah? Good choice?
Yeah.
You look pretty, pretty dapper. Don't worry about it, it was on the clearance rack. It actually was. It wasn't.
Was it?
Yeah. Oh, as God is my witness.
That's my girl.
You to say that it's getting late. Souls in the moonlight. I stare into your eyes and you into mine. Lying perfectly still, like we have frozen time. I don't want this to be over. Don't want the morning to come. My head upon your shoulder. And I hear
sisters, we have come together to get today in the light of the Creator, to share in the celebration of marriage. Ashley and Chad, desiring to enter the sacred relationship of marriage, now present themselves before the Creator in this gathering of friends and family, that their mutual wish to unite as husband and wife may be heard, witnessed, and consecrated. Friends, the Creator who made the heavens and earth, and who breathed life into all humans as its children, has whispered deep into the collective human heart that the Creator is the universal light for all people. We may refer to the Creator by different names and worship in many ways. We seek the Creator in many corners of our existence, most especially the innermost recesses of our being. Yet the light is all-encompassing. Far beyond outward differences of creed or theology, well beyond seeming differences of race, color, or language, is a deep recognition that we are all one. That spiritually, we are brothers and sisters of the same human family, each seeking the path that allows us to love and live in harmony with all humankind. This great Creator is love itself and has endowed us with a capacity for goodness that reaches exquisite heights and can provide the strength to endure the most rigorous of life's challenges. To honor and respect its great purposes, the Creator would have us sanctify this most intimate relationship so that we may find the great joy with which the Creator can endow it. Therefore, we approach this most ancient and most modern of institutions in the spirit of divine hope and in the knowledge of the Creator's sustaining life. Chad and Ashley, your relationship offers you the highest and most intimate experience of love, an ever-growing bond of affection, trust, and mutual respect will bring you into a fuller life than either of you can find alone. As you share with each other your creative differences, your life together will become richer, more complete, and truly more satisfying. The longer you live together, the more you also grow and develop as individuals, so the more you both bring as blessings into this union. The very nature of love is to want to give all to another. This is obviously true of the love you both share, and that brings forth the best qualities in each of you, seeking to break down the barriers of selfishness and mistrust. This love opens the way to a deeper understanding and sensitivity, and enables you to respond more fully to the desires and needs of one another. For it is only through mutual respect that we ensure love never seeks to dominate or possess. As you stand here in this beautiful and high moment, remember that love, loyalty, trust, and mutual respect are the foundations of a happy and lasting marriage. Brother Chad, here in the Creator's light, will you take this woman as your wife, that you may live together in the sacred bond of marriage? Will you strive to love, honor, respect, and comfort her? And will you be faithful to her so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Sister Ashley, here in the Creator's light, will you take this man as your husband, that you may live together in the sacred bond of marriage? Will you strive to love, honor, respect, and comfort him? And will you be faithful to him so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Will each of you here today do all that is in your power to support and encourage Ashley and Chad in fulfilling the promises they make here today? If so, please respond by saying, we will.
We will.
Most of the memories of our loved ones past that we can raise our eyes toward the light. Here we find guidance, comfort, and strength to walk righteously on life's path. Repeat after me, please. I, Chad, take you, Ashley.
I, Chad, take you, Ashley.
To be my wedded wife.
Be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and cherish so long as we live.
To love and cherish as long as we live.
And thereto, I pledge you my life.
And thereto, I pledge you my life.
I, Ashley, take you, Chad.
I, Ashley, take you, Chad.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, or worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and cherish so long as we live.
To love and cherish so long as we live.
And thereto I pledge you my life.
And thereto I pledge you my life.
Great Creator, we ask your blessing upon these rings, that they may always be symbols of love and devotion. Great Creator, eternal giver and receiver of all life, please look with favor upon the world you have made, and especially on Chad and Ashley, whom we bless in your light. Give them wisdom and devotion in the ordering of their common life, that each may be to the other a strength in times of need, a comfort in times of sorrow, and a companion in times of joy. Grant that their hearts may be so entwined in your light, and their spirits from your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and with one another all the days forth. Allow them grace when they hurt each other, to recognize and acknowledge their fault, and to seek each other's forgiveness. Give them such fulfillment from their mutual respect that they may reach out in love and concern for others. And grant that all those who have witnessed these vows may find their lives strengthened and their loyalties confirmed. Bless all who seek it with the comfort of your abiding light. Amen. Of the Creator and of this company, I do pronounce that you are husband and wife. May the Creator of all beings, the heavens and the earth, bless, preserve, and keep you in the light. May the Creator look lovingly upon you both and fill you with that light, that your love for each other may grow and deepen all the days of your life. Amen. By the power vested in me by the Creator's light and the Constitution of the United States of America, I gladly and humbly pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss your beautiful bride. Woo! Mr. and Mrs. Chad and Ashley Sears.
Thank you.
Oh, love will bring you to your knees, to sow the seeds of grace. Your heart of me, of earth and sea, your eyes of time and space.
Grandparents with flowers.
Yeah, that's, I like that.
You know, you dog.
Like a carpenter, I caught your hands from driftwood. Place my veins inside your dreams to woo you while you sleep.
Oh God, all these cameras.
He does not like being center of attention.
And in your heart, I place a charm. Like a garden.
Your golden light, and
and witness this amazing gathering of family and friends. Creator, please bless this bounty that you have provided for us. With it, we will nourish ourselves, remind ourselves of our good graces, and support each other through this blessed life. Most especially, please look down upon Ashley and Chad Seymour and lift them up in your life and in our hearts. Amen.
Put your foot. Put your down, you go down, you lift the leather up, and water overhead. I only heard this like last Saturday, Sunday, and Monday night, the same kind of stuff. You were wondering why things are getting caught up. That's fine. Enjoy.
That is good, too.
Things are getting caught up.
Thank you.
Brandon.
I am honored. These guys are awesome. I could have picked anyone.
Can't you keep my close?
But he picked me.
No.
So I had the speech prepared for a while. Alright, here it goes.
My closer.
For some of us, this is a sad day. But let's be honest, we all saw this coming. He didn't take very good care of himself. He is survived by his fatal... Oh, shit. That's the wrong speech. Here we go. Longer. Chad and I have known each other for a while. We met back in first grade, but we really didn't become close until after high school. And we didn't really talk much in high school because, you know, I took some advanced classes and Chad, well, he didn't. But, you know, not everyone can skate by on four gym classes and home ec.
Algebra 1. Gym?
Yeah, he did take gym. But knowing him that long makes me sort of an expert on what that woman he would need. So I have a little checklist here to see if I actually fit the bill. And I'm not talking about the obvious three. Young, pretty, redhead. I have three others. She would need a lot of patience. Maybe a solid career in working with children. Giving her the skills to deal with this personality. She would need a great work ethic. Ready and willing to do her fair share of the chores. Maybe all the chores.
Double check.
Check. And lastly, she couldn't be shallow or superficial. She would need to be okay not being with the best looking guy in the room. Check. Yeah. And, you know, it took him a while, but he found his perfect girl. And while it hasn't been actually quite as long, I kind of know what type of guy she needed. A guy willing to get the show off his back, even if you don't want him to. Puts family and friends first. Reliable. Can make you laugh on your crappiest day. I mean, just the best guy you could ever meet. So if anybody knows anyone like that, Ashley's just the one up here in the way. I love you guys. You guys are an awesome couple. And, you know, I wish you luck, but I don't think you need it.
No.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Cheers.
Me. I'm Katie, Ashley's proud big sister. First off, I'd like to thank these two for having us all here today and celebrate with them. I'd like to thank all of you guys for coming from near and far to celebrate with Ashley and Chad. I know that they greatly appreciate it. I would like to also thank Robin and Jerry for last night hosting a wonderful rehearsal dinner. It was wonderful. We had so much fun. And then, of course, to my parents, Terry and Vicky, for helping to create this day and make it possible. If we could give everybody a round of applause, that would be awesome. Thank you. All right. So, I would first like to say that my little sister looks stunning, and I know that I haven't seen a smile that big since the NSYNC concert that we went to in middle school, so I know she's very happy. And Chad looks dapper, but you know, that's not different from any other day. And you can hand me that 20 later. So, I've already mentioned that I'm the proud big sister, but what I failed to mention was the fact that I'm also her best friend. All right, yeah, thanks. So, and I mean that in every sense of the word, but those people, they look at our relationship and they envy it, which they should. But it took a lot of hard work to get here, because for anybody who knows Ashley, she was not the easiest child to get along with. I mean, there were plenty of times that, I mean, at 4 years old, Mom and I truly looked at each other and considered keeping her at the grocery store, because she just laid in the center of the aisle and threw a royal fit because she didn't get her way. We almost left her, but I'm glad we didn't.
She still does that.
I know, she still does that if she doesn't get what she wants at the store. But Ashley was the cutest child, with her awesome curlettes and her mischievous little smile. But that's how she fooled you. You let your guard down and you got a bit too close, and then she'd do things like suck your hair up in the vacuum cleaner if you didn't move out of her way fast enough when she was cleaning.
It's your fault.
Or she would lock you in your bedroom when your 87-year-old grandmother was watching you and couldn't climb the stairs to get you out, so you had to wait for your mom to get home from work to let you out. She would also do things like convince your mom that, hey, she had to hang out with you and your friends, but then when it turned the tables, she would go to Mom and say, I don't want Katie to hang out with me and my friends. So I'm surprised I don't need therapy, honestly. Over the years, we've grown extremely close, and she has become the person that I rely on the most, I trust the most, and she's my rock. Yep. So it is true to say that most of her relationships start off just as interesting, and you can't deny that hers and Chad's didn't start off just as interesting. For those of you who do not know about this epic love story and how it began, my sister was not a fan of Chad. I mean, who is when you first meet him?
I was. Thank you.
But he grows on you. So we were at a friend's birthday. They had, Brittany and Evan had a birthday party for their daughter, and they put this whole shindig together, and Chad was standing there talking to his friends, and my sister was standing behind him, and I'm going to paraphrase, but he said something along the lines of, I've lived in East Berlin how many years now? Nobody ever came to visit me. They throw a stupid party for a one-year-old and everybody shows up.
That's so Chad.
So my sister, being strong-willed and she's very outspoken, turns and goes, well, I think this is a great party. And she's like, who's that guy over there? He said, yes. Little did she know that about 2 or 3 weeks later, we'd be at another birthday party, and he would turn on his charm and woo her, and she would become smitten with him from there on. So, where I'd like to go, with that being said, after a few months together, I kind of knew that this was going to stick, because there were 3 things that I started noticing with Ashley. One, she would just light up every time you mentioned Chad. 2, all of the comments that he would make, she started to find them endearing as opposed to offensive. And
it takes a while.
And 3, she would start picking up on some of his catchphrases and use them all the time whether she wanted
not
to
with that
or
attitude.
Not.
Not
with that attitude.
Not with that attitude.
Not with that attitude. So, that's what it is. That's where it's from, right here. But we are very fortunate, because over the last few years, our family has grown. She has found this person who completes her. My parents have finally gotten the sons that they've always wanted, and I finally have the brother I never wanted. Chad and Ashley have done an awesome job of building their life together, and they're off to a wonderful start. They enjoy doing all these things together. They're awesome parents to their fur baby clan. And so, I don't have too much advice to give, but there are a few things. 1, a successful marriage requires falling in love many times, always with the same person. So, never stop finding the things that you love and appreciate about each other. And don't forget to tell those things to each other. 2, a great marriage is not when the perfect couple comes together. It is where an imperfect couple learns to enjoy their differences. So, learn to value each other imperfections and all. 3, I find this one applies the most. When we find someone with weirdness that is compatible with ours, we team up and we call it love. So be sure to embrace it and celebrate each other's weirdness. And finally, for anyone who says a long, loving, devoted marriage is not possible, to that I say, not with that attitude. I love you both. Cheers.
I've got something on my mind. I bet you know what I'm thinking about. You know I can't stop loving you. Every time when you're looking at me, it feels like my heart is skipping a beat, yeah. You know I can't live without you. You make me crazy in a good way. So come on, baby, let's talk. Let's talk about love. Like you and me all night. And let's talk about love. And feeling alright. And let's talk about love. Yeah, baby, come and dance with me. You're everything I'll ever need. So let's talk about love. Take you out tonight, kiss you in the moonlight. There is no place I'd rather be. Come on, girl, we can take my car, drinking some beers in your favorite bar. Yeah, you know I can't live without you. You'll make me crazy in that good way. So come on, baby, let's talk. Let's talk about love.
Yeah.
So what did you say? Since, say, did you mention love? and compromise?
What?
And going to the casino.
And going to the casino.
Franchise.
I'll take it.
Give him a big round. Let's take it. Give him a big round of applause. 53 years. That is outstanding.
It's not like I worked in kitchens 15 years.
Good God!
I'll let you do that part.
That's a big piece. Good God! Please.
All right, I won't cram it in your face. You don't cram it.
Okay. Are they work?
Yeah, I promise.
Yeah, you better walk away. Brat.
There's your first promise, bro.
You make me crazy in a good way. So come on, baby. Let's talk. Let's talk about love. You and me all night, and let's talk about love. And feeling alright, and let's talk about love. Yeah, baby, come and dance with me. Everything you ever need. So let's talk about love. Let's talk. let's talk about love.